at that. You ought to marvel at the sunrise and the sunset. You ought to marvel at that. If you go out there and stand on that old, dirty, nasty Atlantic Ocean, because it's only dirty and nasty right up in the front part where everybody swim. That's why I don't go to the beach. I tell y'all all the time, when folks go out there and do stuff, there's contaminated stuff out there. But when you go further out, say like 10 miles out, it starts to turn navy blue.
Wow.
Beautiful. It is some of the most beautiful water you can lay your eyes on. If you go down south and you go down to Florida, it's where you can walk in it and you can see the sand. It's crystal clear, very salty, but crystal clear. Beautiful. You know, marvel at God's creation. If you've ever been to the mountains, when I was in California a couple of weeks ago, the mountains in California are beautiful. If you ever look at the mountains or the sunrise over the mountains, it is one of the most beautiful and serene, peaceful looking things there is. You don't have to go to LA, go to Shenandoah Valley. Shenandoah Valley has some of the most beautiful mountains. We have some of the most beautiful mountains right in Virginia that runs into Tennessee and West Virginia. Beautiful. When I tell you beautiful, I'm talking about when you up there on that mountain and you at the top and you look down in the valley, look like God put his hand in. Beautiful. Everything is just so, it looked like something that just, it looked like a picture somebody took. Beautiful, but you up in the mountains. And so you take advantage of that. We're not talking about God's creation, what he created the earth. We're talking about what Satan has done here on this earth. Do not love this world. The evil world system is passing away. God is transforming us and giving us a new life and preparing us for the new world, which is going to be heaven. And this is going to be turned into a new world too. Whereas we are part of this new world and we are not under the power of the evil one or under his authority, but we are under the authority of the Father. We are these who are motivated and characterized by doing the will of God, and therefore we will abide forever, because that last verse says, but the man who does the will of God lives forever. Y'all get that?
That's right.
But the man who does the will of God, the man or woman, because you got to put woman there too, the man or woman who does the will of God lives forever.
Right.
That just means you're going to die in this flesh, just
that's
going
right.
back to the dirt.
Right.
But you are going to live throughout eternity with God.
Yes.
You will live forever. You will never die. And that's why I tell y'all, don't get hyped and don't be tripping off of I'm dying. Okay? Because you've got to do it. And of course, sometimes we don't want to leave this world. We don't want to leave our loved ones. We don't want to leave our friends. We don't want to leave our vocations, occupations, whatever the case is. I don't know what people be going through when they die, but guess what? If the Lord let me know, if there's any inkling of a warning that I'm getting ready to go away from here, I ain't thinking about none of y'all. I ain't trying to be funny.
No, Lord.
I ain't thinking about the world. I ain't thinking about this church. I ain't thinking about no job. I ain't thinking about no money. I ain't thinking about how to get no bills paid. Because if I know that I'm dying, and I'm getting ready to go away from here, I'm trying to take a mask. I'm trying to get a mask. I wish I had I'm trying to get my soul right.
That's right.
With the master.
That's it.
Because guess what? I can't take none of that with me. Paul said to Timothy, when he wrote to Timothy, he said, you didn't bring nothing in this world, and you ain't going to take nothing out of this world. So you know what that means? You shouldn't even have your mind on this world.
My Lord.
You shouldn't have your mind on nothing in this world.
My Lord.
You ought to be making your peace with God and asking, Lord, please, save my soul.
Thank you, Lord.
If your soul ain't right with Jesus, you know you're dying, you better make your peace.
Yes, sir.
Ask the Lord, you better be like that thief on the cross.
Remember me. That's right.
When you enter into your paradise, into your kingdom, remember me.
Right.
Yeah. Jesus said, this day. God, I like that.
Yeah.
On your deathbed, you ain't did nothing for God
all your life. This day.
Jesus said, this day.
Yeah.
You'll be with me.
Yeah.
See, he was dying. And he know he wasn't coming off that cross. And he got it. He kicked in. You're the Messiah. You're the one they were talking about.
Yeah.
You're the one that's going to get me into the good graces of the cross.
Sir.
Remember me.
Remember me.
Remember me.
Yes, sir.
Not this world.
That's right.
Not what this world can do for you.
Yes, Lord.
Because you shouldn't be in love with this world.
I know.
If you were in love with the world, the Father's love ain't in you. You don't love the Father.
That's right.
And so it's a lot of people that struggle with that stuff. Let me close by saying these last words because I have another piece. Because I don't want y'all to worry. Right. And it goes with this because, you know, Matthew 6:34 says, don't worry about tomorrow.
No, no.
God loves you so much. And it goes with that Jeremiah 31 piece. See, you've got to hope for your future. So he doesn't want you to worry about tomorrow.
No, 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 no.
He wants you to trust in him. He wants you to depend on him. So that's where my hope is. My trust and my hope is in the Lord.
That's
if
right.
he takes the last breath from me, I'm going to go and be with the Lord.
Right.
That's why I tell y'all with confidence, I know my Redeemer.
Right.
So I know that when I leave, listen, when I leave from here, I'm talking about this side of joy.
Yes.
I know where I'm going.
Right.
Because he already told me so.
Yes.
I believe him.
Amen.
I trust him.
Right.
I take him at his word.
That's right.
Amen.
Let me finish with this because I ain't going to do this other piece. I'm going to do this other piece. I just don't want y'all to be worried about tomorrow. Because tomorrow has its own troubles.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And you don't need to get lost in it.
That's right.
You need to trust him. Okay? And so it is not because we do the will of God that we live eternally, but because we belong to him and have received eternal life that is manifested in our obedience to him.
But
this thing is all about when you come to know the Lord, your life should change.
My Lord.
You know, when I, quick example, I'm going to close. When I gave my life to Christ, he shut down everything that I so-called thought I loved.
My Lord.
Took my Mercedes from me and shut it down, Lisa. Took my Benz from me. That was my pride because that Jake was sweet. That was one of the baddest cars in all of everybody. Shut me down. All my drug money, shut me down. Broke me from nothing. Where I had to rely on somebody to feed me. God would send people to Cliff House and they would give me a blank check and say, you put it in numbers. The money's in the bank. I had that happen to me. This is when I gave my life to Christ. Shut me down. Shut me down from my family.
My Lord.
The ones I loved the most. And I was just trying to live right. Everybody started hating on me. You think you're better than me now. You think you're better than me. Now, I don't think I'm in it, man. I think I'm in Jesus, though. I love the Lord. Set me down, stripped my whole life that I thought that I loved Troy. Stripped it. And I'm glad. I'm glad about it because now, see, what's happening is now, see, Deacon, I don't have feelings. See, I don't care about driving an Explorer.
That's right.
That's 17 years old.
That's it.
See, back in the days, I wanted to be, cat daddy. You know what you call me. Sam called me cool daddy, cat daddy, somebody. He called me somebody, cat daddy, somebody. Back in the days, I thought I was cat daddy. You know, dressing in the best clothes and designer clothes and jewelry. And hey, if anybody could do anything I want to do, he stripped me of all that. Stripped me of all that. Friends, people that didn't have my best interest in their heart relationship. Made sure that I got away from them.
Oh, no.
Even some family members. It would only let me come back around them when I got myself.
Oh my God.
See, because I couldn't judge nobody. Couldn't be a hypocrite.
Oh, no.
Had to be right. Be able to share with them what I have now. Stripped me of the world system. Took the world out of me. And so I'm saying that to say this and then give me the clothes. Don't y'all be judging people. Because you don't understand their position and where they are now. Because of the fact that they're not living like you're living. Or they're not doing the things you're doing. You know why? Because God is stripping them. Just like he stripped you. And he stripped all of y'all in here. Because all of y'all in here been through some of the stuff I've been through. Might have been different stuff, but he stripped you of it. He let you know what was more important than that stuff.
Because
that stuff is going to be left back here.
That's right.
When you die, that stuff is going to still be
here. That's right.
You're going to be using it or abusing it or whatever it
is.
You don't work hard for all your life. Blood, sweat, and tears. And they're going to tear it up.
Yes, sir.
They're going to take everything.
Yes, that's right.
Going to go sell stuff.
Right.
They ain't got no money going to sell
right.
stuff.
That's right.
Going to sell
that's
your
right.
most important stuff.
That's
that
right.
was important to you.
That's
you
right.
going to sell it. Yeah. Don't need it to them.
That's right. Don't. You don't. You're talking, Doc.
Amen.
Stripped us. See, because he doesn't want us to get it twisted. It ain't about stuff, it ain't about things. It's about him and the benefits he has offered. Now, I'm sure that some of y'all in here have been blessed more in your life now living for him than it was when you was back in the day. Now you don't have to watch over your shoulder. Now you don't have to worry about whether somebody's going to try to do this to you, do that to you. You don't even hang with them people anymore. Now you ain't got, because you ain't borrowing no money. You ain't loaning no money. You ain't got to worry about that sort of stuff. Because you don't do those things anymore. He's changed your heart. He's changed your mind. You don't do the stuff you used to do. You don't go to places you used to go. You don't talk the way you used to talk. You don't think the way you used to think. That means the Father is living in you. That's what that means. The love of God is in you. He's changing you. And don't get it twisted. Don't stop the process. Don't keep being you. Keep being you. Keep doing what you're doing because he's doing something with you all the time. Don't get in his way and step in and act like you're doing him a favor because you're not. Stop trying to do his job and let him do his job. You just yield. You just yield to him. You just yield to the Holy Spirit. You surrender that mess, and after a while, by and by, he'll take it away. It'll be like, you know, you don't even miss it.
Yeah,
miss
it. Yeah.
Yeah. I used to cuss all the time. Mm-hmm. I mean, just, you know why? Because even though I was a smart guy, I was ignorant. Because I didn't know how to put the right words into a sentence, so I would use my first four or five words, they were curse words. And then the other two, maybe three words, would make my sentence. Troy know what I'm talking about, being a saver, being a native. And you know, I'm just saying, cuss you out. But just it was everyday language. It was part of my everyday language.
Yeah.
Because I didn't know the right words to say to make a profound sentence. And so now God has stripped me of all that. That was one of the first things he did, and I knew it was a miracle when he did change my language. That was one of the first things he did after he took cigarettes and drinking and drugging away from me, changed my language. I knew it was a miracle. I knew it was God. I wanted to be obedient and faithful to him. Stand to your feet, the Lord. You can't love the world and say you love God at the same time you'll be straddling the fence.